So we are done with simple rubber catheter. The next catheter that we need to talk about, a very famous catheter, and you must have seen it in the wards, that is Foley's catheter. Foley's catheter. So I have one Foley's catheter with me here. So this is a Foley's catheter. Okay, I'll show it to you in close view as well. So this is a Foley's catheter, and we'll talk about the various parts of Foley's catheter when we see the close-up view. As of now, know a few things about Foley's catheter. Number one is that it is a self-retaining catheter. So this is the difference between a simple rubber catheter and a Foley's catheter, that a simple rubber catheter is going to come out. So you insert the catheter, the urine comes out, and then you should remove the catheter. And even if you let it remain in situ, it's going to come out because it doesn't have any self-retaining mechanism. But Foley's catheter has a balloon which we inflate after we insert the catheter, and that balloon keeps the catheter in place. So you just can't pull out the catheter. You need to deflate the balloon and then only you can pull out the catheter. So Foley's catheter is a self-retaining catheter, and that is why it is the catheter of choice when we want the patient to be catheterized for some time. Okay, simple rubber catheter, as I said, the procedure is over, you just want the temporary function. But in Foley's catheter, you may want to keep the patient catheterized for a few days. So what are the uses? The uses of Foley's catheter: this can also help in relieving retention of urine. So it's not that any patient coming with retention of urine, you have to perform simple rubber catheter. That's the simplest method to do. So that is one indication. But if you don't have simple rubber catheter, you can as well as insert a Foley's, no problem with that. And that's what we do a lot of times. We just insert a Foley's catheter, even if the measure is temporary. So relieving urinary retention. The next thing, as I said, that the patient needs to be catheterized. Why? Maybe you are monitoring the urine output. So a Foley's catheter can be also used to monitor urine output. So every time you check the urobag and you know the urine output, because it becomes very important for a lot of cases, especially postoperative cases, patients with trauma, shock, hemorrhage, stuff like that. So in those cases, you can measure the urine output with the help of a Foley's catheter. And we'll talk about the types of Foley's catheter in the close view. Just let me discuss about this. Foley's catheter can be of two types. It can be a two-way Foley's, or it can be a three-way Foley's. So let me just tell you the difference. So here I have a two-way Foley with me. Okay. So here what happens is that if this is the main catheter, the end is like this. So here we have one thing, and we have a side channel like this. So this is actually the main channel. This is used to drain the urine, and this is used to inflate the balloon. This is two-way Foley's. In three-way Foley's, we have an additional side channel. So this is the main channel, sort of. This is the side channel as here, and we have another side channel. Now this side channel is used for irrigation. So we insert fluid via this channel. It goes into the bladder, it collects all debris, clots, and etc., and then it drains that out through the main channel. So another use of Foley's, that is three-way Foley's, is irrigation of the bladder. So another important use is irrigation of bladder, and this is three-way Foley's. A Foley's catheter can also be used for suprapubic cystostomy. So what is suprapubic cystostomy? In this, we don't insert the catheter via the urethra. So catheterization means inserting the catheter via the urethra into the bladder. But if we have an indication not to insert a catheter through the urethra, maybe we have urethral injury, suspected urethral injury, or maybe an obstruction which would not be relieved with the catheter, it would cause bleeding and stuff like that. In those cases, in order to relieve the bladder, we have to perform a suprapubic cystostomy. That is, we have to approach the bladder from the skin over the pubic bone. That is suprapubic cystostomy. So we directly insert our catheter into the bladder. So Foley's catheter can also be used in suprapubic cystostomy. It can also be used for urethral catheterization. Following urethroplasty, that is construction of the urethra. So these are the major and important uses of Foley's catheter. It's meaningless to study, you know, thousands and thousands of uses of a surgical instrument, because at the end, in the exam, maybe you'll have to study hundreds of instruments, and if you study hundreds use of each hundred instrument, then you can imagine how many uses you're going to study. So you need to focus on the major uses for surgical instruments, and this is enough for the exam. So we have Foley's catheter, which can be two-way and three-way. Two-way, I'll show you. Three-way, it's just like two-way, only having a side channel. That is why it is three-way. And that is used for irrigation of the bladder. Through the third channel, we insert fluid and then we irrigate the bladder, and through the main channel, we take that fluid out. The side channel is always used to inflate the balloon of the Foley's. And Foley's is a self-retaining catheter. This is a very important term. Two other things that you need to know in Foley's catheter is the size and the balloon capacity. The balloon capacity, we'll have a close look. The balloon capacity is mentioned on the pack. The size is also mentioned. The balloon capacity is usually 30 to 50 ml. Now the size can be anything. The size is mentioned in French units. That is why it is written as FR. So it can be 16 French, it can be 18 French, it can be 12 French, whatever. Okay, and there is a color coding also on the side channel. You don't need to remember the color coding. Okay, so what does this size indicate? Now we have a great deal of controversy with this size. Okay, so we have huge controversies, and a few sources say that this 16 French or whatever, this French means the circumference of the catheter in millimeters. The other sources mention that it is the diameter of the catheter in millimeter. Okay, so the second sources feel that 16 French means that the diameter of the Foley's catheter is 16 millimeter, and the first source thinks that the circumference of the Foley's catheter is 16 millimeters. So there is a great deal of controversy. I don't know who is correct, but I think personally, if you ask me, it is the circumference, because this is the French unit, and I had searched a lot of, you know, books. I have searched a lot of topics. I have searched a lot on the internet, and I have come to the conclusion that maybe this is the circumference of the catheter in millimeter and not the diameter. So if you answer circumference, the examiner might ask you, then what is the diameter? It's nothing. So circumference is what? The circumference is 2 pi r. So 2 pi r is 16 millimeters. Right, the circumference. So what is the diameter? Diameter is 2r, twice of radius is diameter, so it is 16 divided by pi. So pi is about 3.14, so just do some mental calculation and it would be 5 point something, I guess. So you may clarify this controversy from your professors, that what to answer, whether it's diameter or the circumference. I would personally go with the circumference. And in simple rubber catheter, please mention this point there as well. In simple rubber catheter, we also have a number. Say we have number 10. So number 10, this indicates the diameter, but this doesn't mean that the diameter is 10 mm. Here also it is not direct. This is the English scale. Here, to derive the diameter, you mean that the diameter is equal to the number on the catheter divided by 2 plus 1 in millimeters. Okay. So if we have a 10 number simple rubber catheter, then the diameter is 10 by 2 plus 1, which is 6. So this is 6 mm. I think the measurements of the catheters are quite complicated. Okay. So English scale, no FR or anything written. For example, number 10, that is simple rubber catheter. Here the diameter is this number divided by 2 plus 1. In case of Foley's, FR would be written, indicating that we are using the French scale. And that is the circumference of the catheter in millimeters. So you need to divide that number by pi, which is 3.14. So this is it. So now we'll have a closer look at the Foley's. So this is a Foley's catheter, Foley balloon catheter, as it's written here, siliconized. Okay. So the main part is this, where the size is written. And as we have discussed, this is the 16 French. So 16 FR is written, as you can see. So it is 16 French, and this 30 to 50 ml is the balloon capacity, as we have discussed. So manufacturing date and date of expiry. This is sterile. So all those markings are here, sterile, and EO means sterile by ethylene oxide. So we have talked about sterilization and disinfection in our general surgery topic. Okay, so this is the Foley's catheter inside the pack, inside the sterile pack. And as you can see, this is a two-way Foley's catheter. So this is the main channel. And this is the side channel. Here also the size and the balloon capacity is mentioned. And this color is the color coding. So 16 French is orange. And as I've said, you don't need to remember the color coding. At the tip, as with simple rubber catheter, we don't have an opening in the front. We have it only in the side. So let's open this Foley's catheter and have a closer look. So this is a sterile pack and we need to peel it off like this. So we have opened the Foley's catheter and it comes in another sterile packaging. So we remove the outer packaging. So this is the Foley's in the inner packaging. And here we have a part to tear off and then take the catheter out. So we can either take the catheter out from the tip end or we can take the catheter out from the this end, this terminal end. So here I am not maintaining any asepsis, but in the real world you need to maintain asepsis and take out the Foley's catheter, because otherwise it is going to cause urosepsis if you insert an unsterile Foley's. So let's open this. So we have opened this and we have taken this thing out. So this is a Foley's catheter. This is the tip. This tip is blind but has holes on the side for urine to flow through. And this is the other end. So this is the main channel, the drain. And this is the side channel. And this inflates the balloon. And we actually have the balloon here. You can feel it. Okay. So after we have inserted the Foley's catheter, we need to inflate the balloon. So we take, what do we take? We take distilled water in a syringe and we inject about 20 ml of distilled water. The balloon capacity is 30 to 50 ml. In clinical practice, 20 ml is sufficient to inflate the balloon. So we inject about 20 ml of distilled water and inflate the balloon. So a lot of examiners ask, what is the fluid used to inflate the balloon? It is not normal saline, it is distilled water, because normal saline, it contains salt, right? So they may get precipitated in this balloon if the catheter is to remain for a long time, and they can cause problems. So that is why we use distilled water. And this part we connect to a Euro bag. So this is all about Foley's catheter. Let's have a closer look once more. So this is 16 French, 30 to 50 ml balloon capacity, and the color coding is orange.